Hi, everybody. It's Bankai922 here. Okay. One Piece episode review. 559. This one, I'm going to give it a 4 out of 5. I would go higher. But, you know, really, the majority of this episode was, but it was pretty fucking cool, though. Pretty good one. It still was a good one. Basically, what ended on happening was, we had the Noah chasing after Shirahoshi. So, we have Luffy is about to be launched by Sanji into the Noah and grab its chain and get up there. But while this is going on, the citizens are really upset because, you know, Shirahoshi is being chased by Noah and there's nothing they can do. What happens is, we all know what happened last week because, you know, he attacked Shirahoshi with a knife. So she's bleeding from the arm. And Sanji's about, he's about to launch Luffy. And I think Jinbei gives him a few words. He says, be careful, Luffy, up there, because you know, you're going to have a big time disadvantage in the water. Just saying. You know, he was saying to him, and, you know, seeing as how that, you know, as he said last week, Jinbei, Deccan, Vander Deccan is a Devil Fruit user, so he's in an area on the ship that has air, so, pretty much. So, Sanji's about to launch him, he launches him, and he doesn't use too much of his strength. Luffy is able to, grab the chain, and so is Hordy. Hordy Jones is up there, too. And they're moving along. And like I said before, the citizens of Fishman Island attempt to grab the chain and try to slow it down. And at this point, Luffy's already on the chain at this point, you know, and as it goes along, going along. Then, Hordy Jones just, you pathetic fishman, and he does a shark arrow at them, and they all fall down. And, you know, Shirahoshi's like crying, you know, she's really like, you know, it's a desperate situation. She feels very powerless, I would say. Very, very powerless in this situation. And she doesn't know what to do. So she just keeps chucking around, turning around, going through. Eventually what happens is she's thinking to herself about the where she can go to get the ship away from the island, away from the bubble. So she's able to find the hole that leads to the palace. And she goes through the hole and she exits into the sea and she goes that way. The ship then follows her, obviously, and, you know, freaking Deccan's like, ho, 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 you know, having his little speech of, you know, Shirahoshi, at one point, he says, just say yes, and then she's like looking at him and says, but you're not my type, and he's like, ah! I thought that was funny when she said that, but also what's happening is, Luffy's upset, obviously, that this happened, and he goes through the wall, out of the water. Can't breathe. So he has the air bubble, but as a result, he's not what he used to be now because he's in the water. And Hordy Jones is like zipping through the water and it's attacking him relentlessly here and there. And Luffy can't hit him at all. It's a big difference. Eventually, what happens is the bubble breaks, Luffy falls, and it's like, uh oh. First time Luffy is disadvantaged since this, you know? But here comes the princess. Fubayoshi, I think his name is? Forgot his name. Oops, I apologize. Very bad with names. He shows up to help Luffy. And he's able to throw away the spear that Hordy Jones threw. And gives him an air bubble, and he takes him away. And then a fight breaks out between those two. Meanwhile, we have Shirahoshi, and she's still running, still, you know, she decides to go down out of the sea, and she going down near the sea floor. And that's when Deccan decides to throw knives at her, and she's like, ah, you know, freaking out. Here comes her brothers, the two other brothers, and they save her. Of the three princes, the other two brothers come and save her. And we basically have them saving her. And they told her that you shouldn't do it that way because we have to make sure that the ship, Noah, that isn't damaged. So, decide to go. Shirahoshi starts going up. And meanwhile, we're having this all-out battle between Luffy and Horty Jones when, well, he's on Fukuboshi's back, the oldest prince, they're going through these columns, and freaking Horty Jones puts this steel shark fin on his back, and I'm like, wow, and he's cutting through the undersea mountains and shit, and I'm like, wow, this is going crazy, and there's smoke and stuff, and he clears the smoke, Horty, and that's when they see the ship going up. Now, the end of this episode was actually a precursor for what really is to come next week. So they decide to go up. And Horty Jones decides not to attack Luffy, saying, oh, I can kill him anytime I want because we're in the water. I need to take care of something else. He's going to go to kill Deccan. And like I said before, Deccan said, oh, she says, you're not my type. Like, ah. You know, he's so shocked. He's saying that he's going to kill her, oh, and she'll be forever in his heart. I'm like, come on, what are you fucking joking? Really? And then here comes Horty Jones with killer intent. Killing intent. And he's just standing right in front of him. He's like, oh, Horty Jones. Like, you know, he's got that saying, Deccan, and he's like there. And Horty just goes up to him, and he says, would you mind if you, what? Die? And he stabs him. He's like, ugh. I had blood coming out of him. It was so ridiculous. He's like, what hell happened now with the Noah? Now that he stabbed him. Pretty much, I think what happens with Deccan now, because he got stabbed and he's pretty much dead, Noah is going to fall. And he's probably going to fall on the island. And this is going to actually... something else. It's going to put up something else for next week. So, yeah, this should be interesting. This should be really interesting for next week. And that's pretty much what happened. Like I said, it's a slow episode. This wasn't really... not a lot of stuff happened. Not too much happened. But stuff did happen. I'm giving this a 4 out of 5 because... oh, man. And it was good. It was great. But, you know, to see, like, Horty Jones now, all of a sudden, oh, he's big and bad now because he's in the water. I'm like, come on. Oh, just because, oh, yeah, you know, he's in the water, and, oh, he's begging. Come on. Yeah, but if Luffy goes and fights you where you are now, you're not going to be so tough, are you? But anyway, we ride along. That's pretty much what happened. Thoughts on it? Pretty good chapter. I mean, it was good. Wasn't as great as the other ones were, though, the past few chapters. And I think next week's going to be really good. Really good. So, we'll see, you know. I really like the One Piece anime. I really, really do. Bye. We'll see where this goes from here. Digging the Horty Jones. Imagine if sharks... I'm just thinking about this. This is a stupid question to ask. Imagine if sharks had that on their fins. And they just go like... and they just kill fish. That would be awesome. He killed these two fish over there. So that was pretty awesome. But anyway, that's all I got for you guys. 4 out of 5, One Piece. You know, I don't know what I'll call this episode review. I don't know. But it was pretty interesting to see Horty Jones look, what, strong now? I mean, Luffy was kicking his ass for the last 2 or 3 episodes. You know, now all of a sudden you're in the water. You're big and bad. Yeah. Oh, come on. Jump off. But that's all I got for you guys from Bankai 922. I See you guys later.